Mid-air scare for 55 Spartanburg High School students and chaperones. They were on board that AirTran Airways flight forced to make an emergency landing Friday in Colorado. This after an unruly passenger caused a disturbance. That passenger, Muhammad Abu Tahir, is now facing federal charges. News 4's Johnny B. talked to one upstate passenger about what happened.
He was pointing a finger at one of the flight attendants, saying and talking to several of the other men that were there, saying, you know, she's disrespected me. She's disrespected me. He just kept repeating that phrase.
James Dunn says he was one of several men who flight attendants called to the back of the plane where Tahir was seated.
Put his hands on the chest of one of the men and just kind of like making an emphasis, but not in a in an attacking manner, just out of emphasis.
Before the argument began, people in the back of the plane had already become suspicious, Dunn says, because Tahir had been spending a lot of time in the bathroom shaving. Dunn says a flight attendant told him that Tahir started to become argumentative after having several servings of wine, and she told him to slow down. That began a 45-minute episode that set the crew and some passengers on edge.
There was talks amongst the men. Should we take the man down? Should we not take him down? And the talk between the flight attendants and the men that were standing there, that things were okay right now, that, you know, we didn't need to make things worse by, you know, having altercation.
Dunn says some of the flight attendants brought electrical cords, zip ties, and more to the back of the plane in case the man needed to be subdued.
It's kind of funny now, but it wasn't funny at the time when she handed, like, one man the coffee pot and another man the pot of hot water to make tea with in case we needed to burn him and to subdue him.
He says eventually the crew allowed Tahir to go back to the bathroom to finish shaving, then pushed a cart in front of the door to keep him inside. He was arrested after the plane touched down in Colorado Springs. Dunn's wife in Spartanburg didn't know what her husband and daughter had been through until the flight was over and the rumor mill was churning.
My daughter was on Facebook and she was saying, this person's saying that daddy's a hero and he's the one that subdued him. And James said, no, that was not what happened. But anyway, so, you know, there were just a lot of stories all afternoon and into the evening.
But one part of the story that Dunn does not dispute is that alcohol played a major role in creating the emergency.
I think this whole thing would have been averted, if that guy had not, had that much to drink. And unfortunately, you know, his life is probably ruined.
And that was John Eby reporting. Dunn tells News 4 reports of a cart being pushed in front of the cockpit door to protect the pilot were untrue. He also says reports of Tahir being tasered were false. He said he heard an officer warn Tahir that he could be tasered, but it never happened.